Awesome. My wife and I had. And what she was doing in the bedroom was looking for her record. She had to get it together. Now see, I keep my record on me at all times for such a time as this. Which is biblical as well, such a time as this. You never know when you're going to need it. So I keep my list. And my wife's up there, and she starts listing off all the things that she don't like about me, all the things I had done wrong since the last fight that she had started with me. And I pull out my list. And I start listing off all the things that are wrong about her, all the things I don't like about her, the things that she's done wrong, the way that she is responsible for everything that is bad. And the fight starts to grow and grow and grow. And neither one of us remember the present. We're fighting over things that we have never dealt with. At that time, we had been married almost 6 years. And we had, we've been together 7. And we had 7 years worth of stuff we owned. We were throwing out stuff from when we were dating at each other. Stuff that she had said and done, stuff that I had did to her that she didn't like, that she had never said she didn't like. And what happened is, when she would say these things, it hurt me. Because I'm thinking, you think that about me? Well, let me hurt you then. Let me tell you what I think about you. And I would hurt her. And then she had to beat that. She had to hurt me. And we kept tearing each other apart. As the fight grew, and as our pride grew, and as our anger grew, it got to the point as we were screaming into the night at each other. It got to the point to where, and I hate saying this, I've told this 1,000 times in front of thousands of people. And every time I get here, I stuck my heart kind of drops a little bit, and I think, how are you going to receive this? What are you going to think about me? And I screamed at my wife. I looked in her eyes, and she is beautiful. I wish she was here. She could see how beautiful and fragile and pure and strong and all these things that she is. But I was so angry that I screamed at her that I was sick of living with her and I wanted out of my marriage. I didn't leave. I told her I was leaving. I told her she could have everything. I didn't care. I built it. I could build it again. I didn't need her. And I didn't leave. We just kept fighting. Because she hadn't yet admitted she was wrong, I guess. I was going to keep fighting until I got through. But something good happened. This is crazy, but because we kept fighting, something good happened. We got to the end of the fight. And I say it this way, I say that there was a victory. There was a victory on the other side of the fight. We sat down on this little daybed together and we were talking to each other and crying at each other and apologizing for things we said and realizing that we just let it get out of hand over all this stuff. And is it really, can we figure out a way to not fight each other so much, but to fight for each other? Can we just make a turn here? And let's just say, as hard as we've been working against each other, let's fight for each other. Let's try it. Let's just try it. I'm going to fight. There's so many things I want to keep saying. There's so many things I want to say. I'm going to fight that. I'm going to fight that thing in you that wants to tell you that you're less than me. I'm going to fight that. You fight that thing in you that wants to point out my lies. Fight that as hard as you can fight that. And maybe we can get through this. We went through some counseling and talked to a lot of pastors. I get to travel all over the country and meet a lot of great people. And I ask a lot of questions. The Bible says there's wisdom in a multitude of counsel. And I saw a multitude of counsel. And through it all, I started writing this song. It's just the way that I think. And I started